Hey everyone, welcome to Topperly. In this lecture, we'll be discussing about phase plane analysis of nonlinear systems. Phase plane analysis is mainly used to analyze second order, linear or nonlinear systems. This method can be used to study the nature of phase trajectories near equilibrium points. Another point about phase trajectories is that closed curves in the phase plane portrait show the presence of limit cycles. There are many methods to construct a phase trajectory. However, in this lecture, we limit to three methods only. They are, the first one is analytical method. The second one is graphical method or isocline method. The third one is delta method. Now, without wasting time, let's discuss the analytical method. Suppose you are given a nonlinear differential equation of the form y double dot plus f of y y dot equal to 0. Okay. Now, this equation can be easily put into phase variable form as y equal to x1, x1 dot equal to x2, and x2 dot equal to minus f x1, x1 dot, which is equal to minus f x1, x2. Right? Now, we will combine these two equations in the form of dx2 by dx1. So, this dx2 by dx1 can be manipulated as dx2 by dt by dx1 by dt, which is nothing but minus f of x1 for my x2 by x2, right? Therefore, we can write it as dx2 by dx1 equal to minus f of x1 for my x2 by x2. Now, if we cross multiply the terms, we get it as x2 into dx2 equal to minus f of x1 comma x2 into dx1. Now, if we integrate on both sides, we get the equation as x2 equal to some function of x1, right? Now, this equation over here, when plotted on an x1, x2 plane, gives the phase trajectories. For example, suppose x2 equal to x1, that is phi of x1 I have written as x1 itself, then the phase trajectory is given by this line. Okay. Now let's see an example based on analytical method. The question is, given the equation y double dot plus y equal to 0, draw the phase trajectories. Let's see how to do this. First, write x1 equal to y, x1 dot equal to x2, and x2 dot equal to minus y. This much you can obtain from this equation, right? Now we can write dx2 by dx1 as minus y by x2, which is minus x1 by x2. If we cross multiply this equation, we will get as x2 into dx2 equal to minus x1 into dx1. Integrating on both sides, we get as x2 square by 2 equal to minus x1 square by 2 plus c square. If we rearrange this equation again, we will get it as x2 square plus x1 square equal to k square. Now, we can see that this equation represents a family of circles centered at origin. So, the phase trajectories can be drawn as, suppose this is the x1, x2 plane, then the phase trajectories are given by a family of circles centered at origin. So, these are the phase trajectories. Okay. You can keep on drawing more concentric circles around it, which are also part of the phase trajectories. Okay. Now, we will move on to the second method, that is isocline method. The procedure for isocline method is the following. We will consider an example to explain these steps. So, let there be a nonlinear differential equation given by y double dot plus y dot plus y equal to 0. Now, the first step is to define the state variables as y equal to x1 and y dot equal to x2, and get the state equation as x1 dot equal to y and x2 dot equal to minus f of x1, x2. So, we write as y equal to x1, x2 equal to x1 dot, x2 dot equal to minus x2 minus x1. Okay. Now, the second step is Determine the equation of isoclines as dx2 by dx1 equal to n. We find dx2 by dx1 as minus x2 minus x1 by x2. And we will equate this to n. Okay, where n is the slope of trajectory. Okay, now we will rearrange this equation as x2 equal to minus of 1 plus n into x1. Okay, moving on to the first step. For typical values of n, draw a large number of isoclines in x1, x2 plane. Now, in order to draw the isocline, we need the equations of isocline. So, let us make a table for that. Okay, so this is a table. Now, suppose I put n equal to 0, then I get the equation of isocline as x2 equal to minus x1. Let us plot that on a graph. Okay, x2 equal to minus x1. So, this is the equation for x2 equal to minus x1. Now, suppose I substitute n equal to 1. Then, the value of x2 becomes minus x1 by 2. Now, I plot that also. That is, x2 equal to minus x1 by 2. So, this red line represents that equation. Now, suppose I give another value, that is, n equal to 2. Then, I get as minus x1 by 3. And if I plot that, we get minus x by 3. And this blue line represents the isocline x2 equal to minus x1 by 3. In similar fashion, I will draw a lot of isoclines. Okay. So this is the completed table and this is the completed graph with some isoclines in it. Now the next thing you have to do is on each of these isoclines, you have to draw a small line segment with slope equal to n. For example, take the case of this yellow line. Here, the value of n equal to minus 1. Therefore, we have to draw a line segment on this yellow line such that the slope of the line segment is minus 1. So, for slope to be minus 1, we need to draw a line segment at an angle of minus 45 degree. So, let's draw that. So, okay, now this line is approximately minus 45 degree. Now, for this green line, we have to draw a line segment with slope equal to minus 2. Therefore, theta is approximately equal to minus 63 degree. So, let's draw that. Minus 63 degree. Now, this is minus 63 degree. Okay. Now, similarly, for n equal to minus 3, we have to draw theta approximately equal to minus 71 degree. Let's draw that also. In this similar fashion, we have to draw for all the isoclines, okay? So, as you can see, I have marked the line segment for all the isoclines, okay? Now, we will start to draw the trajectory. Suppose I take an initial point over here. Now, the first step is to draw a line segment passing through this point. Let me name this point as A. Passing through this point and parallel to this line segment. So, let's draw a line like that. So, now you can see that. So, we will draw a line through A and parallel to this green line segment. Okay. Now, we need to draw another line which is parallel to this line segment over here and passing through A. So, let that line segment be this. So, this orange line is parallel to this red line segment over here and passing through A. Now, the next point in the trajectory can be found by the midpoint of these two points. So, the midpoint approximately comes over here. So, we can trace the trajectory like this. Okay. Now, in the similar fashion, we'll try to find the next point on the next isocline. So, we need to draw a line segment parallel to this line segment and passing through the new point on the trajectory. So, that line segment is this. And we also need to draw another line segment which is parallel to the line segment on this isocline and passing through this new point on the trajectory. So let that be this one. Okay. Now I can mark the points of intersection of this as these two points. Now the midpoint is somewhat over here. So we can extend the trajectory like this. Now in similar fashion, if we keep on drawing the trajectories, we'll get a trajectory like this. Okay. I hope that everyone understood this method, and if you have any doubts, please do ask in the comment section. So I will make another video to explain this further. Okay. Now we will move on to the next method, that is delta method. In the case of delta method, suppose we have a differential equation of the form y double dot plus dou of y y dot plus y equal to 0. Then we will arrange these equations in the form of state equations as x1 dot equal to x2 and x2 dot equal to minus of x1 plus dou of x1 x2. Okay. From these two equations, we will get dx2 by dx1 equal to minus of x1 plus dou x1 comma x2 by x2. Okay. Now, what you have to do is draw a x1 x2 plane. In this plane, plot the dou x1 dou x2 equation. Okay. So, this curve represents dou of x1 x2. Now let us start the construction of phase trajectory. Let the initial point be here. Okay. From this initial point, we will drop a line segment to x2 such that it is perpendicular to x2. Now we will measure the distance between x2 axis and the point of intersection between this line and the curve dou x1 x2. Okay. So let this distance be dou 1. Okay. Now we will find a point on the negative real axis such that the distance between that point to the center is dou 1. Okay. Now what we do is that we will cut an arc at the initial point using this point as the center and this line segment as the radius. So we will cut an arc over here. Okay. Now, to construct the next part of the trajectory, we'll take another point on the trajectory. And in similar fashion, we'll drop a line segment from the point to the x2 axis and take the distance between x2 axis and the point where the curve cuts the line segment, and let this distance be dou 2. We'll mark dou 2 on this negative real axis, and we will cut another arc using dou 2 as center and this line segment as radius. So the new arc will be like this. So effectively the trajectory becomes something like this. Okay. So in similar fashion, you keep on drawing the trajectory. Okay. That concludes the delta method, and I hope that everyone understood this lecture very well. And if you have any doubts, please do ask in the comment sections. In the next lecture, we will be seeing some problems related to what we have studied today, that is analytical method, delta method and isocline method. Okay. So that's all for this lecture. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.